When Korea existed as a few small kingdoms 2,500 years ago, no kingdom was dominant enough to conquer additional territory and unite the peninsula until Silla, one of the kingdoms at the time, united the country. The king of Silla knew that ancient Korean philosophy stresses that the mind and body must exist in a state of equilibrium, and training was instigated among the young males, being strong enough to conquer neighboring kingdoms and unite Korea into a single country. The outgrowth of this initial training was the formation of a group of warriors called Harang-do. Training was continued and improved upon throughout the generations until it was evolved into what is known today as Taekwon-do.
발차기에 들어가는 게 아주 다르고요. 그리고 다리를 접어찬다는 것, 권투처럼 뒤꿈치를 들고 움직이고요. 그 다음에 움직임이 끊어지지 않고 계속 움직이는 거는 이제, 이건 제 개인적으로 봤을 땐 재즈 댄스나 이런 부분들하고도 비슷한 면이 있고요.
Martial arts, it gives you an inner strength, you know, a lot of confidence in all areas, not just the fighting side, but it extends into other areas of life. You know, before now, I'd be jittering and stumbling over my words, speaking in front of a camera. I really hate public speaking. And even though I don't like it now, I'm more confident doing it. And that's not due to doing it a lot, it's due to martial arts and the confidence it gives you. Confidence is probably the number one factor for everybody.
Taekwon-do 이제 하게 되면, 운동을 하게 되면, 이제, 육체의 고통을 이겨내고 잘 되지 않는 것, 그러니까 힘든 것을 이겨내고 하는 것이기 때문에, 자연히 이제 정신적으로도 강해지고, 그 다음에 몸이 건강하니까, 건강한 육체, 건강한 정신이라는 말처럼, 그런 좀 몸이 이제 건강해지니까, 마음도 여유로워지면서, 정신적으로도 더 건강해지는.
Martial arts, discipline, respect. Discipline of your mind, yourself. That's how you can start to learn. Overcoming one's ego, that's the beginning of the journey. You know, emptying yourself out so you can be filled. My master always said this to me, because when I started, I wanted to fight. And he was just laughing and said, listen, young man, we learn martial arts so we never have to use it. Saying that to an 11-year-old, I'm like, huh? But that's the point.
Judo comes from the fighting system of feudal Japan. The aim of judo is to utilize physical and mental strength most efficiently. Judo came into existence as a form of unarmed combat, which were grouped under the general name of jiu-jitsu, or the gentle practice.
One of the unique things about judo is it's very real, you know, they don't jump over for you. If you throw somebody, then you know you've thrown them. Whereas some of the other sports, I think in karate, unless it's full contact, you never quite know how effective it is. Very similar, I mean, jiu-jitsu, depending on which type of jiu-jitsu, is primarily on the ground. If it's Brazilian jiu-jitsu, it's probably 80-90% on the floor, whereas judo is 90% standing up. But it's the same family, and I think they go very well together. I mean, it really is the same thing, but the rules are different. It's more than just a sport. It's really a formula for how you can live your life. That's how I would sum it up. There's the spiritual element and there's the physical element, and it's all of that encompassed into one. It's not just one particular thing. And the feeling, you know, many times I come here to train or to teach, and you feel a bit uptight, and then after training you feel like a weight has been lifted off you. I just think it's hard to put the finger on it, but it just makes you think of things in a different way somehow. Without going into the whole details with the Zen and everything else, but it just broadens your awareness and how you are with other people. There's a certain respect which you get from other sports as well, but judo, I think, or martial arts has this different element to it. The philosophy, well, I think it's different for different people. I mean, for me, it was just a way of life from a very young age. I was 16 years old, I got my black belt, and then at 17 I was on the national team. So it was really, in the beginning, much more of a sport for me. And then, as you stay in the sport longer and longer, it becomes more like a religion. You know, it has a different meaning for myself. It is a way of life, and it's just a learning for life, which is what Jigoro Kano wanted it to be.
A true practitioner of the art should never forget the importance of the philosophical and spiritual parts of martial arts as well as physical ones. Respect is an important subject in martial arts, and it is expected from all students towards their parents and in general towards all human beings. Be like water. It is the softest substance in the world. It can fit into any container. Although seemingly weak, it can penetrate the hardest substance.